So what is a browser cache? Well, browser cache is when an image or some other element on a page is downloaded, saved in a temporary local file. So if that image is needed again, it doesn't have to go and re-download that entire thing. For instance, a website like MacMost will have a logo graphic at the top. And if you visit a bunch of different pages at MacMost, it's the same logo graphic. Why download it individually each time? It's going to use up a lot of bandwidth. It's going to slow down loading of the page. So it recognizes the same graphic is used from one page to the next and looks at the cached version it has. Now, caches maintain themselves. When files get too old in there, Safari gets rid of them. When you're short on space, Safari gets rid of them. So there's really nothing you need to do to maintain the cache of your browser. For the most part, it just operates independently. It's not one of those things you need to worry about. But every once in a while, there's a reason to clear the cache. Because what if the image has changed? If an image has changed, there's no way for the browser to know that. It's going to say, hey, looks like the same image to me. I'm not going to go and download a new version. But if the server has a new version of that same image with the same name, then it can't really know. So in some cases, you may need to change it. Like an example may be a weather widget on a site that's an image showing you today's weather, and it's going to change the next day, but maybe have the same file name, and you're just going to get the old image instead of the new one. Here's an example here where, say, I'm working on my website, and I have an image here on a page, and I'm going to change it on the server. So I'm going to update the server here and change it so it's a new image that has the number 2 in it instead of the number 1. Now look what happens when I refresh the page. I'm going to hit the Reload This Page button here, and it's still going to show me the number 1 in there. But I know the image has been changed on the server. So I want to clear the browser's cache. Now one way to do this is to go to Safari, Preferences, and from there click Privacy, and you see where it says Manage Website Data. You can bring that up, and this will allow you to clear the cache only for that one website. Now you can click Remove All, and it will remove all of the caches for all of the files and all the sites. But it will also remove cookies and things like that, which you don't necessarily want. It means you might be logged out of a lot of websites and you might have some pre-filled stuff that disappears. But if I wanted to, I can select MacMost here and I can hit Remove, and it will remove the cache and cookies for MacMost. And then I can hit Done. Close that. And now when I refresh this page, since it doesn't have a cached version of this image, it should seek out a new one. And you can see now it gets the correct one from the server. Now there's another way to clear caches. If this is something you need to do a lot, like you're a developer and you're changing the images you have on your server a lot, or even if you're just a publisher, you're just publishing to a blog a lot and you want to make sure you see the updated graphics there, you can go to Safari Preferences and then click on Advanced and click Show Develop Menu in Menu Bar. Now that you have that on, you've got this extra menu here, and you can see that there is an empty caches item there. And the keyboard shortcut for it is Option Command E. So you can either select that, or you can use Option Command E if it's something you do a lot to clear all the caches. And the great thing about that is it doesn't clear the cookies and other things like that. It just gets rid of the cached files. Now I want to show you a case where this doesn't work. When you go to Preferences and you go to Privacy, you go to Manage Website Data, and it brings up something, and you notice there's two websites here that have data there. I'm going to select just Remove All to get rid of everything there. And you think, great, it's cleared all my cache and all my cookies. But hold on a minute, because if you wait a second, those two sites appear again. Well, what's happened there? Well, it's just a glitch. It's a bug that's been around on Safari for a little while. I think most of the stuff that you see, the cache and the cookies, have been removed, but certain types of databases that are used, you know, probably just to remember like who you are, like if you've logged into those sites, that kind of thing, they stay there, and it can be a little bit annoying. So if you want to really clear the cache out and you want to do it right from the source, here's what you do. You go to the Finder and you go to the Go menu, but you hold the Option key down so you can select Library. And this will bring up a window here that is your library. And your library, you can go down into Safari. From Safari you go to Databases, and then there's usually a folder in there, and then here's where you see some folders. And you can see those are the two sites that it had trouble getting rid of. So I can select those two folders, delete, and now they should be gone. If I go to Safari Preferences and I go to Manage Website Data, nothing should show up because I've removed those folders. So if you run into that glitch, which happens every once in a while with a certain type of data file, but you really want to clear out all your cache, that's the way you do it.